So this afternoon we're going to do some product testing, but first, how are we supposed to put liquid paper on a bee with no lab coat?
Yes. Yes, please.
We got him. We got him.
Hi.
Hey.
Hi.
G'day, mate. So today we are going to show you a little bit of the science that goes into making our products. We're going to show you a pressure test and flow test on some air boxes.
We run a neoprene gasket, which is closed cell, same stuff as your wetsuit material. It clamps down on the flange and creates a perfect seal. We're going to prove it.
We also use silicon joiners with hose clamps, but today we're going to show you with airflow and air pressure that they are a perfect seal.
And the reason why they're a perfect seal is we run a 4 or 5 ply silicon, which just holds its strength.
Our vacuum tester, ready?
Vacuum tester.
Yeah, vacuum pressure tester. All right, so this is our neoprene gasket that we're gonna put on now. It is cut specifically for this airbox.
We're gonna put a little GoPro inside so that you can see if there is any smoke.
We're gonna run smoke around the outside while we vacuum test. We are gonna suck the pressure out of the airbox, which means it's drawing air from outside. And then we're gonna run the smoke machine around the outside. If any smoke gets in, the GoPro inside will catch it.
Fun fact, bull dust is anywhere from 20 to 60 microns. Smoke is 0.2 to 60. If smoke won't get in, neither will bull dust. All right. So we run an acrylic lid on all of our air boxes, like so. Nutserts into the flange. And then we run M6 button head bolts. We're gonna use negative pressure to simulate a car under load with a hand over the snorkel, really.
Do not test this at home.
You don't have lab coats, you can't do it. So when you're doing up your airbox, you wanna go in a star pattern, much like your wheels or anything that is a pressure plate.
Why do you do that?
So you don't snap it.
So that you get equal pressure across the thing?
Yeah, so you get equal pressure and it all comes down as one because of the gasket.
And if you zoom in here, you can see that it is just squeezing down on that neoprene gasket. We make them quite thick so that once it squishes down, it sprawls out a little bit, create an even better and full seal.
And also the beautiful thing about neoprene is it has a 90% bounce back rate. So if you leave it out for a bit after it's been squished down, it will
bounce back.
Yeah, bounce back. So you just want to tighten down until you feel it start to be a little bit tight on the threads. So I'm going to grab a straight edge, run it across there so you can see the negative pressure when we do crack it. Be back. Would you like to do the honors, my love?
Sure.
So I'm going to do it nice and slowly because I haven't done it before with this one.
Safety goggles, please.
So,
check that angle. Okay, so we're now running the smoke around the outside while it's holding a negative pressure on the inside. So if it is to suck in, the lid will bounce back up and it will suck in smoke.
Now remember that bull dust is 20 microns and this is about 0.2. It's a lot smaller than bull dust, which is the main concern for air boxes.
See the gap underneath the middle here.
What do you reckon? Should I crank it more? See what the breaking point is?
Yeah, stop. So, I'm going to move my hand away though.
Okay. So I've never actually done this before, but I want to see at what point does it fail.
And we're going to keep running the smoke around the outside to see if it does suck in.
Okay. Say when. When. We're at nearly negative 20 kPa. 0.3 bar.
The lid is still holding, no craft.
0.7 bar, sitting at 0.7.
Does that mean that it is drawing in?
Well, I thought the lid was going to break, so turns out lid's pretty strong. So, I say that's holding pretty well. I actually thought the lid was going to break, turns out it isn't.
It doesn't look like it's sucking in from anywhere either. And you can see here the bow that we have on the lid in the center. Bottom of the airbox here, we've got our drains. This is after the test that I'm showing you this. They also have their own little neoprene gasket, so nothing escapes out of there. And once done up, it is obviously a full seal, but it has a catch in it so that you don't lose the actual drain plug.
So for day-to-day driving, you leave it out, let it just dangle. And then when you're doing some off-roading, going through a puddle, then you can tighten them up. We always put them in an easy to reach place so you can reach underneath and undo it. We think of you. There's now.
Okay, so here we have the factory NP300 airbox. We've got the GoPro inside. We've blocked off here. And then we've got the pressure thingy ding on this side. And we're going to put the air filter in to make sure that it's sealed.
Pressure thingy ding.
It's a pressure thingy ding.
Yeah, the vacuum tester is a pressure thingy ding.
It is.
Okay. Factory. This is what Nissan intended for you. So, without further ado. So they run plastic locking tabs.
Like we're going to be very careful not to break.
Got a locker in. So.
It's all closed up.
If it's sealed, it'll negatively pressure. If it's got holes in it, it won't. So, let's crank her up.
We're ready.
Nothing.
Feel the air blowing out. We got it blowing in. I'm going out. It's got it blowing in.
Huh?
It's got it blowing in.
Whoopsie. Well, my bad.
Okay. Start again.
What a goose.
Okay, so now we are sucking all the air out of the airbox to see if it pressurizes. Is that an exhaust reading?
No. Zero.
If the smoke sucks in.
What's happening?
Any pressure?
Still zero.
Okay, do you want to put positive pressure in now and see if any smoke pumps out? There's already smoke coming out of the corner here. There it is.
Obviously, we know factory airboxes don't seal at all. For the purpose of this video, we're going to go through and block up all the little holes that they've got and see what happens.
So we're actually pumping smoke directly into the airbox through the same valve that we were using before, just to show where the smoke comes out from.
Turns out it's everywhere. So wherever smoke comes out, water will get in and dust. So that's the benefit of having a drain plug that you can put on and off as you please. But in saying that, for day-to-day driving, we recommend having your plug undone all the time. Because it is sealed, it'll turn into a fishbowl. And then you don't want that. There is one thing to take into account, and that is that around the perimeter from top to bottom is actually sealed. So it is filtering dust and everything, but it's more so the bottom side letting things in. When dust and water come together, it makes like a PVA glue substance that just coagulates and blocks your filter very quickly. So let's block it up.
Science.
So we're gonna use some RTV silicon and roofing screws.
Super RTV.
For the Bogan fix.
Again, we don't recommend doing this as it does completely seal the bottom of your airbox, not allowing any water to get out.
So we're gonna leave that for a little bit to cure.
Jinx, you owe me Coke.
Oh my God. Is it on? All right, is it done?
It's not dry.
We'll get a licky test.
That hit the back of your throat. It's stuck in the back of your throat.
Why is it tasty? Okay, we've plugged it. We're going to test it. So hopefully we can blow it up.
And taste the...
spicy.
So it's already leaking. So that's a good sign.
It's leaking here.
It's leaking from this contraption here, which is less than ideal for your full driving needs. But it's not leaking from here.
And it's still not leaking from the top, which is also a good sign.
So our Bogan fix semi worked.
Alexander Helpful.
Sorry, my name's Alexander Helpful.
Oh my God, we're like twins.
So what the anemometer does is it reads airflow, velocity, CFM, miles per hour, kilometers per hour, knots. So basically it will give us a CFM reading, which most turbos, intakes, anything car related run on CFM. We overloaded it. Can we use your Milwaukee shoebox?
We're going to get our baseline using this handy dandy little blower.
Milwaukee blower. We used the still, but it overloaded it. So we're just going to go for a lower CFM reading. Go from there. Ready?
Ready. .16.81 was the highest reading I got.
Okay. And we got a fancy dance little converter that we'll punch them all into once we are done, so we can get all the CFM readings.
Doing meters per second.
That is our baseline. Now we're going to hook it up to our airbox and see what happens. Now, the reason we want to do it without a filter is to show how the box flows with nothing in there, without any restriction whatsoever, and it'll give us a baseline of how restrictive or not restrictive the filters are. Get our little Milwaukee blowy boy. Say when.
When.
.17.93 was the highest I got.
How does it flow better?
Meters per second.
Yeah.
Just flows better. Probably because it doesn't have the direct feed straight into the turbines.
There you go. So now, with our filter in the airbox.
So these are our new Meredith Metalworks pod filters that were being made. They have the Meredith logo on the top there. They are a cotton blend on the inside with a stainless steel mesh. So it's very, very durable. And then it's got your silicone top and bottom. So it's easy fit. These are reusable, they are oilable, and they are washable. Shouldn't we be doing a sucking, not a blowing?
Well, how is we don't, that won't suck as fast as it needs to. And essentially it's blowing it.
Because the turbo would be here, sucking.
Yeah.
Through here, not blowing.
Well, it's the same action. So whether it's blowing in or sucking, it's the same action.
Okay. I just think it's going to be a really low reading and it's not going to be usable.
So I do think it's going to drop, but I don't think it's going to be zero.
My hypothesis is that the reading is going to be zero because we're not sucking from this end. Instead, we're blowing air into the airbox. So I think it's going to be zero.
Oh, no. Well, if it's zero, we'll just cut everything out of the video and then pour butane on our hair, do haircuts.
Is that what happened to you?
Yeah. Freak bender accident. What?
Moment of truth.
Don't. What are you doing?
Highest reading I got was 16.98 meters per second.
Stop this.
Which means that it's only dropped just under 1 meter per second with the filter on, which is pretty fucking good. That filtration is amazing.
Filtration is amazing or the flow?
Well, the filtration.
The filter.
Which does what? Amazing results. Thank you for coming along to Meredith Meth Labs. Now. Okay. So that concludes our time here at Meredith Science Lab. We have now proven that our airboxes are very, very durable. The lids are amazing with that huge bow that we had in it. The airflow is great, even with the filter in it. We only dropped 1 meter per second airflow when I thought it would be zero.
Positive outlook. It's not, there's no air.
But there's some things. It's blocked. We had sucking, we had blowing. Okay, so thank you for coming along and see you on the next one.
Like and subscribe.